The Adobe Animate CC program creates Flash files. These files have the extension of .fla. The only people who can view the .fla file are people who own Adobe Animate CC or an earlier version such as Adobe Flash Professional. That leaves out a lot of people who potentially want to see this project or actually use it if you're creating an app or something of that nature. So you can't just save a Flash file and expect it to do what you need it to do. There's always the last option where you have to publish the file in a format that other people can see and use. The most basic of these options is to create a SWIFT file that can be viewed in an HTML page, which means it can be seen on any common browser. For this particular project, we want to create those particular settings. In order to do that, we go up to the File menu and choose Publish Settings. This is where you can choose a bunch of different formats to publish to. In general, you always want to create a SWIFT file from the original Flash document. You also usually want to create an HTML wrapper file, which essentially creates an HTML page that houses the SWIFT file so that people can play it in a browser. With each of these formats, there are a bunch of options that you can choose from. Read through these carefully, and what I would recommend is choose a couple of options, publish it, test it out, and see if that's what you wanted. For right now, the basic settings will work the majority of the time. So for this one, we just want the SWIFT file and the HTML wrapper. In order to publish it, we can click Publish. When we do that, wherever the original FLA file was saved, it will create the additional HTML file that also houses the .swift file, or .swf. This is probably the most common form of publishing a Flash file. But it's not the only thing that you can publish. You can also publish GIF images and make them animated or static. You can export JPEG or PNG images, an OAM package which works with other animation programs, an SVG image which works really well in modern browsers, and then a Mac projector and a WIM projector. These are separate executable or app programs that just play the Flash file without an HTML, without the original Flash file, any of that. It's just kind of like its own mini program that will play this project. So if you have no other options left to you, try a Mac or WIM projector and that solution should work. I highly recommend that you go into Adobe Animate CC's help files and look up the different options and things you can do with these formats so you can learn what you can and can't do and all the features that are available to you so that you don't get stuck doing the same old thing every single time. So in addition to publishing HTML and SWIFT files, you can also export different JPEGs of kind of screenshots of each of your frames. So for instance, I want to take a screenshot of this particular frame. I can either go to File, Publish Settings, and choose JPEG Image, or I can go to File, Export, Export Image. This is when I can choose where I want to keep this project, and it's always going to export to wherever the original Flash file is saved. So if I accept that location, I can choose Save. And then it'll ask me options about how big do I want to make the stage size? Do I want it to match the screen? What should be my resolution? If I wanted to print this out for my portfolio, I'd want to change the resolution to 300 because that's the accepted resolution for print. If I wanted to put it on a social media site, I could leave my resolution at 72. That's the common accepted resolution for digital media. You can also choose to include the minimum or full document size and what quality you want the JPEG to appear. So if I click OK and go to this project folder, you can see that I now have a JPEG image of that particular frame. So I can move on later to another frame and take another JPEG of that particular project. If you're using an HTML5 canvas and you go to File, Publish Settings, you'll notice that you have fewer options or different options than what you had when you were working with an ActionScript 3.0 document. Once again, I recommend that you read through the Adobe help files on all the different options or just test them out by trying them one by one, publishing and seeing what they do. Last but not least, you can always publish your projects as video. So this is great if you wanted to, let's say, add an animated sequence to your actual video that you're creating for a video class or working on a video project for home, friends, family, whatever. In order to do this, you need to go up to the file menu, choose export, and then choose either movie or video. So it kind of seems like it's the same thing. Let's choose video first so we can talk about that option. So when you choose video, you can choose what size of the video it should be. So we've already created our stage size to be a common YouTube dimension. And then we can choose to ignore the stage color. And then we can choose to convert this video in Adobe Media Encoder. So this option you can use, but for some reason when I do it on mine, it takes forever to load Adobe Media Encoder. So for me, I just uncheck that and then open Adobe Media Encoder later and then encode this video to, because right now it's going to make it a QuickTime movie. Those are really, really big videos, and I don't need that big of a video to just upload it to YouTube. If I was making a DVD or a Blu-ray, then definitely yes, I would need the QuickTime movie. But if I'm just putting it on YouTube, then I don't need it to be that big. So that's why we would need to convert it in the Adobe Media Encoder. So it'll also talk about when should it stop exporting or after a certain time has elapsed. So for this one, it's not actually saving to the exact same project folder. I need it to though. So I'll go to browse and choose this class and choose Chapter 5's project and click save. So it's going to the right spot. And I think that's all the settings I need. So I can click export and it's going to make a Swift movie first and then it's going to export it as a .mov file. So if we look in this project right now, we see the movie being created and it has the Swift and just let it go all the way through. So once it does, you can open that up in an Adobe Media Encoder and convert it to an H.264 video, which works well for YouTube. There's another video on that in my YouTube channel, so make sure to check that out. So the other option we had was to export as a movie, and this is just a little bit more, I guess, simplified or not as robust as our previous option. We can choose to create a GIF sequence, a ping sequence, an animated GIF, or a Swift movie. So it's kind of what we've already seen before, but it's kind of a quicker, simpler interface. So you can always just choose one of these and hit save. So we don't want to save for that one. We have our QuickTime movie. And again, if I were to show you how big this was, it's 1.12 gigabytes. And this is only, let's see, this is only 320 frames long. So whatever the math is for that, 13.3 seconds. Thank God it does that because I'm horrible at math. So anyway, for 13 seconds, it's 1.12 gigabytes. That's huge. That's why this needs to be converted to H.264. But the whole point of this video is to get you thinking about your different published settings and knowing what you need to create and why you're creating it before you even start the project so that you can first create the correct document type, so whether it's Canvas or an ActionScript 3.0, and then making sure that you publish with the right format so that other people besides people who own Animate CC can actually see and use your project.